Hello, friends. It's Carolyn from Chain 344 checking in with you on a very icy, snowy day here in Wisconsin, which is okay with me. I'm actually, like, really okay with it being snowy. My son Ernest has a cold, which is really sad, so we are having, like, a super chill day. And he's kind of one of those kids that just wants to be left alone when he's sick. So he's chilling, watching Netflix. Baby girl is asleep. Henry has a dog toy full of peanut butter. And I had a few quiet minutes, and I thought that I should do some vlogging. Yes! I don't think this is gonna be super long. Now, having said that, it'll probably be like 2 hours. But just a little quick chat about some stuff that's been up with our lives. So Kate and I spoke on October 17th at the Knitting Guild in La Crosse, Three Rivers Knitting Guild, which was really super fun, and just, it was really great to see all those local knitters and people who had been in the shop, people who haven't been in the shop, and see kind of what their guild meeting was like. And it was a huge honor to be asked to speak. And I was super on it and technologically smart, and I brought this GoPro with me to record it, and then I didn't frame it up, so it cut off our heads the entire time. So that video will probably never see the light of day, unless you want to, like, watch our kneecaps and hear, like, really muted us talking. And I would feel really creepy about, like, messing with the audio so that you could understand us better, but then you still can't see us, and it's just, like, our knees. Like, I feel like that's maybe creepy. I still have the footage, so I maybe will do that someday, but I just... it's creepy. Regardless, that went great. So, hi, if any of our viewers are from that. Really happy to have you here viewing our podcast. Very exciting. Me-wise, stuff that's happened lately, we took a trip down to my parents. We did some harvesting of soybeans, which was really fun. Rhinebeck happened, so there was lots of me doing this and looking at Instagram. We're being invaded. Hey, Ernest, what's up?
I need peanut butter.
You need peanut butter?
Yep.
Okay. Let's go get some peanut butter. I'll be right back. And we're back. Yes, like I said, sick kids are, it's the worst. It's so sad because he's such a happy guy. He's still pretty happy. Whatever. It sucks because I was up all night. And he's super energized in the morning. Mom's out there. What are the physics of that? How does that even happen? Like, your kid stays up all night and doesn't feel good, and then the next morning, after sleeping for approximately 42 seconds, they're super energetic. So, other cool things that have happened, if you follow us on Instagram, I'm obsessed with Stranger Things now. I just started watching the show this past week. Like, I'm not into horror. Oh, I don't like super creepy scary, and Stranger Things is right at the threshold of, like, possibly will give me nightmares, but it's so good, I can't stop watching it. I haven't had any nightmares about it yet, probably because I just love it so much, which is really silly, but yeah, my husband and I don't usually get into horror. He's really not as much into Stranger Things as I am, but I'm, like, way far gone. Like, if you follow us on Instagram, you saw that I sculpted some Eggos and put little maple syrup E on some of them, and 11, like the 1-1 on the others, which is, like, nerd level too high. But I've really been enjoying that and been doing a lot of knitting and Netflixing since the weather has turned to winter suddenly. And lots of wearing of really woolly woolies, which is nice. For me, I like it. Some people don't. whatever. Knit-wise, Kate and I have been doing a ton of shop sample knitting, which has been really fun to, like, knit something and then hang it up and then see other people get inspired by it, and then they pick different colors that you, like, wouldn't even expect, and then they knit it, and it's awesome. Like, oh, it's the best part of the shop. Seriously, the best part. Like, teaching people to knit and crochet, like, new addicts. That sounds bad. New knitters and crocheters being born. That's super cool. And the other super cool thing is just the insane vortex of creative inspiration that happens. That's my tablet. People just, like, they're so inspired by something that one of us did or someone else is doing at the shop, and then they're like, oh, but I would do it with this. And you're like, I would have never picked that, but that is awesome. And it looks so cool. And it's just all the different perspectives of crafting, all the different walks of life, like, oh, so cool. Nerd. Yes, so something super exciting that I am super excited to work on. Possibly the last time I vlogged, I was working on a colorwork hat for Caleb. And I said that I really loved it, and I was like, probably should take a break from fingering weight for a while. And then I told Kate, mostly, I told her, like, don't let me cast on any more fingering weight projects after I finish the couple that were on my needles. And she was like, lol, okay, that's gonna happen. And I was like, what do you mean? I love worsted weight. I'm totally not gonna knit with fingering weight for a month. So I decided after I finished the fingering weight projects that were on my needles that I really did need to not use fingering weight projects for a while. I really would, like, decay and up for a while. So obviously that means I have to pull out my Find Your Fade and finish it so that I have no more fingering weight projects on the needles. Instead of just continuing to let it hibernate. Because it's cheating if you're like, only fingering weight for a month or so, but you have one hibernating. That's my mind. That's what happened. So I pulled out my Find Your Fade for the first time in a long time. And I counted how many rows I had left to do when I first pulled it out. And there were 186. Which, to me, at the time, thinking, I was like, oh yeah, I only have like two more color sections to do, so that's not that many rows. That's not that much. And then I started doing the math of, like, how many stitches it's gonna take to do that many rows, how huge it is, and I was like, okay, let's just light this on fire and never do it again. Or let's power through it in a couple weeks and make it be the only project that I take with me on our road trip 2 weeks ago, which I did, and I've been powering through it. I'm literally 5 hours away or less from finishing it. I'm gonna say less, but I'm gonna say five because, like, let's be real, interruptions, and there's never a day where I can sit for 5 hours and knit. I probably could be sitting and knitting right now, but I'm talking to you, and it's fine because my shoulder hurts from last night's knitting binge, which is ridiculous. The way I was curled up, okay, like, I'm curled up in a blanket, but I still wanna knit and watch Stranger Things, so I did, like, one of these. Have you, like, the ridiculous knitting pose where it's, like, right up next to your face? You're trying to knit. Okay, maybe I'm the only one. But I know you've hurt yourself knitting, not, like, in a bad hand way, but in a, like, I was sitting. Or, like, you're cramped in the backseat of a car. Or a jet ski. I don't know. I think other people have done it. So let's talk about the fade. Dun, 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 dun. It's huge! I am super excited about this. Really, the main reason I pulled it out is because I've been wearing my Void shawl every single day. Except today. Almost every single day that I go out in public and see other humans, I wear my Void shawl because it's the biggest shawl I've ever knit. I love wearing my hand knits. It's alpaca. It's baby alpaca, so it's ultra squish. And it's huge. And did I mention it's winter now in Wisconsin? It's snowing.
like actively, like right now. And I hate the coat with the, when you have the bun and then the coat and then the hat and then the coat pushes on the hat and the bun. No, Carolyn does the shawl like up to your ear holes. Like that's fine. And then usually probably still a hat, but I just, okay. The winter wear is great, but there are frustrations. Okay. So my fade, after wearing the void shawl like every single day, I was like, I need another schlanket. I have one that's almost done. I should finish it. In addition to the, it's cheating if you have one on the needles and you say you don't. Okay, so this is Dye Monkey, Earth Day. We're gonna go super fast. We're not gonna talk about how much I love everything. This is Kickapoo Sock from Utopia, question mark colorway, I don't remember. Something green, like Carolyn's favorite color, colorway. This is Bumblebee Acres, Apple Orchard. Let's drop all the stitches. This is Zauberball Crazy in some, like, it's just numbers. I'm pretty sure the colorways are just numbers, which is kind of annoying. This is Knit Picks Stroll Tonal Sock? Wait, yellow? Whatever. Like, honestly, I love how the yellow transitions, but it's kind of the least exciting of the yarns I have. Because all the other ones are like, fun, local, indie dyers, whatever. And then this is like, oh, it's Knit Picks. But it's a great yarn. Like, I don't know why I'm getting so yarn snobbish lately. One of the side effects of owning a shop, which we'll talk about a little bit more in a second. And then here, this White Speckles is Dragonfly in Amber by Bumblebee Acres. And it is...
I need peanut butter.
You need peanut butter?
Yeah.
We need lots of peanut butter today.
Big peanut butter.
A big peanut butter? Okay. I'll be right back. Henry is covetously looking at that peanut butter. That dog loves peanut butter. Like, I know dogs love peanut butter, but like, whoa. Henry loves peanut butter. Okay, so this is Bumblebee Acres, Dragonfly in Amber. It is a Outlander-inspired colorway. I still haven't really even finished the first book or like put a dent in the book series at all. I haven't watched the show either, but I know I want to. Anyways, it's beautiful. This is their Corriedale base. I said I wasn't going to talk about how much I love everything, but I love it so much. Okay, the last color is... it's hard to say, but I think this fade, I know it's not the most fadey of fades, but between the bumblebee and this blue gold Malabrigo here, I think that's my favorite fade section. It might not be picking up, but the bumblebee has so much of the blue gray gold in it, and these two play together so well. It just makes me super, super happy. So I have, if you're familiar with the fade pattern, I'm not gonna like let any secrets out, I don't think. Each one of those stitches translates into approximately two rows to knit. So this is about 36 rows left, maybe less now, I haven't counted. That, a row takes me about 10 minutes. 36 times 10. They had me do math on stage once, and it was bad. I don't know. 36 times 10 minutes. 360 minutes. 6 hours. I said 5 hours. Dang it. 6 hours to finish this. Plus bind off. And squeezing and crying. I probably will just block it with tears of joy. I don't think I'll need an actual warm water soak. I think I'll just use my happy tears. I'm very excited. Like, my entire family thinks this is a blanket. And they're like, it's kind of a small blanket. I'm like, it's a shawl. It's kind of a big shawl. Like, yeah. That face all the time. Okay.